Okay, so remember that when we are simplifying, like we are on target one, we're just combining like terms. So we're going to start off slow here, looking at number one, x minus 5x would be negative 4x, and then 6 plus 1 would be 7. Negative 4x plus 7 would be your first answer. We can't simplify that any further. Number two, we're going to start off by distributing. So I'm going to distribute that negative. And then I'm going to distribute the negative again. Now we're going to combine like terms. So we have quite a few x's here. So we have negative 8x plus 22x, which would be at 14x, minus 4x would be 10x. And then we have negative 7 plus 8, which would just be 1. Taking a look at number 3, no parentheses to worry about, so we're just going to look for like terms. I see a 6 minus 2, which would be 4. Then we have a 2x minus 3x, which would be negative 1x. And then nothing else is alike. So we have a 7y, we have a 4x squared, but we can't combine any of that. So this would be an example of a really ugly answer, but it's actually correct. And then again, on number 4, looking for like terms, 2xy minus 6xy would be negative 4xy. Then we have two terms that have an x, so 6x minus 14x would be negative 8x plus 7y that doesn't combine with anything. And then on number 5, we have some fractions. So we are going to distribute those since we have parentheses, always going back to that order of operations. So negative 1 half times 18x would be negative 9x, and then we would have a plus 11, and then we're going to multiply by 1/3, so that would be plus 3x minus 4. And then combining like terms, negative 9x plus 3x is negative 6x. And then we have 11 minus 4, which would be 7. And just as a side note, you can definitely write this as 7 minus 6x. The order doesn't matter in which you write those terms. So your answer might look slightly different, but still be correct. All right, so moving on to target two, solving an algebraic equation. So still using some of those simplification tools, but our final answer will be an x equals or whatever the variable may be. So on number six, the first thing I'm going to do is distribute the two. So that'd be negative 6 minus 10x minus 5. And then I'm going to combine some like terms over here on the left hand, or sorry, the right hand side. So negative 91 equals, that would be negative 11 minus 10x. And then I'm going to add 11 to both sides. So that would give me negative 80 equals negative 10x. Divide by negative 10, divide by negative 10. We would get x equals 8. Now, number 7 definitely looks a little intimidating. I'm going to start just where we always do. The first thing we would do is distribute. So that's what I'm going to do. Starting by distributing the negative out in front. Remember, that's like a negative 1. So that would be negative r minus 22 over 5 plus 9 over 4 equals, I'm going to distribute the 2 now, so 2r minus 1. So same thing that we've always done, we have to combine our like terms. So we have to do negative 22 over 5 plus 9 over 4. And if you want, you can definitely find a common denominator. A great common denominator to use would be 20. What I'm going to choose to do, you can also use the ABC button on your calculator. That's always a great tool to use in these cases. What I'm going to do is just throw this into the calculator without using the ABC button. 9 divided by 4. And so if I combine these two terms, I get a negative 2.15. And so it's definitely less scary as a fraction, sorry, as a decimal than it was as a fraction. Okay, so continuing on, I'm going to add this 1r. And in the same step, just because I'm running out of room, I'm going to go ahead and add this 1 over. So I get negative 1.15 equals 3r. And then I'm going to divide both sides by 3, and I'm just getting myself caught up in my calculator. Divided by 3. So if I divide both sides by 3, and again, I've just gone to fractions here or decimals. 0.383, repeating, but we'll just round it right there. If you wanted to use fractions instead, definitely okay. Either way is great. All right, on number 8, continuing to solve, think about your orders of operations. So we're going to leave this 3 to start with and distribute the negative. Again, just a very common mistake that we see. And then distribute the negative 2. And then we're going to combine our like terms. So 3 minus 2 over here on the left is 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and add 3v over. So I have 1 equals v minus 12. And if I add 12 to both sides, I get 13 equals v. On number 9, so we're getting into those literal equations, which means we're getting a variable by itself, but it's kind of an ugly way to do this with all the variables. So if we want to solve for w, I'm going to go ahead and subtract 2l, but I can't combine that with the p, so now we just have p minus 2l equals 2w. But to get w by itself, I have to get rid of that 2 out in front, so I'm going to divide this by 2, which means I have to divide everything in that equation by 2. So combining like terms, simplifying where we can't do anything with the p over 2, but we have 2 over 2 here, so those actually cancel out, and we're just left with an l equals w. And then our last problem from this homework, we're going to get pi by itself in this formula. So there's a multiplication symbol in between the r squared and the h, but there's actually also multiplication happening between the pi and the r squared. So if we want to get pi by itself, we actually want to divide by r squared and h to cancel both those out, but we have to do it on both sides. So for our final answer, we have v over r squared times h equals pi. And that's your homework for targets 1 and 2.